Oh
my gosh.
Oh, no.
There are people out there. Mr. Carl Tatz. This is his idea. So blame him.
Well, no, don't blame me. Yeah.
This is a hell of a peep show.
Thanks everybody for coming.
All right. This is it. So I'm going to start off with a song that Mr. Josh Leo and I wrote some years back. This is on my...
They're still talking about it.
Still talking about it. In fact, I have a recorded on my recent album, which will be out here in May. And so here we go. This is called Rocked in a Country Cradle. True story. Those records in my basement all alone. Dad said that ain't music, not like I walk the line. I couldn't hear him, I was heading for a hard day's night. I was rocked in a country cradle, moon shining in my eyes, cricket in the wall sang me a song. I learned to harmonize. I was rocked in a country cradle, both sides of that track. Raised a little cane when that mystery train rattled our little shack. I was rocked in a country cradle. Still feels the same. The radio still plays, but something has changed. Dad knows all the words to yesterday. Mama just smiles to hear us all sing together again. I was rocked in a country cradle, moon shining in my eyes. Cricket in the wall sang me a song. I learned to harmonize. I was rocked in a country cradle, both sides of that track. Raised a little cane when that mystery train rattled our little shack. I was rocked in a country cradle, moon shining in my eyes. Cricket in the wall sang me a song. I learned to harmonize. I was rocked in a country cradle, both sides of that track. Raised a little cane when that mystery train rattled our little shack. I was rocked in a country cradle.
Dana Cooper, ladies and gentlemen.
How does he do it?
How does he do it? Well, he strums on that thing and then he sings.
I thought it was with volume.
Oh, well, you know, it's all the stuffs. So we're going to be trading some songs. So Dana's going to sing a tune, and consider Josh. I know we're two dashingly good-looking dudes, but we're going to be considered one so tonight. So there you go. As you know, musical collaborators and such.
Just as musical.
Hey, come on, bud.
I mean, nothing wrong with it, but just, yeah.
Hey, so, yeah, our turn will be one, and then Carl's going to sing you one. So we're going to tell some stories. Some of these are true. Some of these are half true. Some of these are complete and utter bull.
You have to decide which ones are true and which ones are bull.
I may or may not tell you. So, yep. This one starts just outside of Innsbruck, Austria.
As it turns out,
I'm far too old to die young now. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Very nice.
Thank you, Carl.
So, you're going to hear some really good singers up here. I'm not one of them. Sorry. But maybe I'll make up with it for some of my songs, hopefully. This is a song about a small town.
It is my turn?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I didn't know if it was.
Yeah, go ahead. I mean, I don't care.
I'm sorry. I think it was Carl's turn. I might have jumped the gun.
No. We're going left to right here, depending on which way you're facing.
Okay. Anyway, this was...
What's that cologne you're wearing?
It's called Embarrassment.
It's pretty good.
Anyway, this song was... I had the privilege of being a producer on Music Row for a while. And one of the bands that I got to produce for a while was a band called Alabama. And they recorded one of my songs when I was producing them. And it was this song right here.
One, two, three, four.
I just stopped for the beaten path, a little dot on a state road map. That's where I was born and where I'll die. Things move at a slower pace. Ain't nobody in a rat race. These days it's a special way of life. Down home, where they know you by name and treat you like family. Down home, where a man's good name and a handshake are all you need. Folks know, if you're falling on hard times, they can fall back on. Those of us raised up down home. In the corner of the hardware store, I gathered round a checkerboard. Old men telling lies and crowning kings. Kids driving round the old town square. Tops rolled down in the cool night air. Go and see what's shaking at the Dairy Queen. Down home, where they know you by name and treat you like family. Down home, where a man's good name and a handshake are all you need. Folks know, if they're falling on hard times, they can fall back on. Those of us raised up down home. When I was a boy, I couldn't wait to leave this place. Now I want to see my children raised down home. Take it, Phoenix. Folks know, if you're falling on hard times, they can fall back on. Those of us raised up down home. The song was written about Franklin, Tennessee in 1991, because it was kind of like Mayberry back then. That's before all the people from L.A. moved in. Oh, yeah. So I moved out to College Grove, thinking I'd be safe out there. Who's going to come out to College Grove, right? Except a golf course and a bunch of people from L.A. with million-dollar mansions. So now down home is East Nashville. Down home. Thank you.
Not to utterly confuse you, let's go to Carl. Take it away, Carl.
All right, Carl.
Carl, I won't do that next time. I'll wait.
Okay.
By the way, Carl, no pressure. That song went to number one.
Yeah.
Just want to let you know.
This song hovered in the charts for weeks and then finally dropped out. Or not.
Truth or half-truth?
Truth or half-truth?
Don't you know, you fool? She's wrapped up in a bow. And I said, can I be sure she's the real thing? She laughed. You already know. I read the book you said was so good. I read the first page to the last. I didn't know it was about us and a love that always lasts. I took it to the fortune teller. She knew exactly what to say. I watched her stand up on the table and crack a smile as bright as day. Don't you be sure she's the real thing. She left you already know. Her eyes were bluer than that blue sky the day we walked up on the hill. Your picture to remember of what would be and always will. A seaside walk out on the jetty. The mist was hanging soft and low. I took your picture to remember, and it always stops to show. Don't you know me, fool? Be sure she's the real thing. She loved you already know. There for the taking, but you may never know.
Beach to that.
Yeah, maybe so. Let's be real.
Thanks for the accompaniment.
I think that was...
Thank you.
Didn't Brooks and Dunn cut that song?
Yeah.
That's what
yeah,
I thought.
They got a hold on it.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, so I've been working on a new album, and Josh is on there, as a matter of fact. And a bunch of friends are on there. This is a little song I wrote in after an evening in Tucumcari, New Mexico. This is called The Ghost of Tucumcari. And on the album, this features my old friend Lyle Lovett singing along there with me. His voice just kind of fit the mood of this song, really. Stay in a little funky hotel there, motel, and it was about to snow that night. It's getting cold. Loading the equipment into the room, and there's a old battle-scarred tomcat came limping across the alley and stood in front of a dumpster that had a lid open on it, and he looked up there like he really wanted to jump in there, and he just couldn't do it. Kind of limped away. I grabbed a can of dog food. I keep some pet food in the car for strays, and I went and tried to feed the cat, follow him across the highway. He disappeared under some old buildings across the highway there, old Route 66. It's called Ghost of Tucumcari. Keeps the back door open for the ghost of Tucumcari. It hurts to see I'm hungry, so desperate, so wary. The temperature is falling, tonight there'll be a flurry. She leaves her heart wide open for the ghost of Tucumcari. The lost one from the shadows limps across the alley. His haunted face is bloody from his never-ending battle. He sleeps for no one sees him beneath the old abandoned building. No cruel hand can reach him. The ghost who took him carry. Oh, I taste the silent snow on his sandpaper tongue. Remember his warmer days, the blinding desert sun. He's scared to death of man, but he's too damn sick to run. So he'd stay out here and die cold, or step inside that open door. Once the lights burned bright in the town of Tucumcari, now people just blew by. The old mother road is lonely. She sees him through the curtain, prays that he will tarry, sleeping in the corner, the ghost of Tucumcari. So peaceful in the corner, the ghost of Tucumcari. 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 Oh, Tucumcari.
Carry a can of dog food in your car?
I do. For strays? Those nights when I'm, snack.
That isn't just for the song.
Truth or half truth?
You don't have to think about that.
So, I frequently fly, we journey, we travel around and, sometimes make enough money to pay for our plane ticket. Well, you actually probably do better than I in that regard.
I drive.
See, smart. They don't let dog food through the... No, I'm just kidding. One particular evening, I hopped a flight over to Los Angeles, and the edible I had taken before I took off, it was wearing off. So I landed in L.A., and as I do, usually I stop by the first dispensary I can find. And I picked up a little resupply. And there I was, GPSing to go meet some buddies over in Studio City. And the jumped on the 405, which is the world's largest parking lot. And it redirected me, and it took me up into the hills. And I don't know, you know, I don't know why, but when I got up there, I looked up, and it was dark. And if you've ever been to Hollywood, L.A., or, you know, the Valley, that's not easy to find, but this particular evening I looked up and I could actually see stars. And that's worth writing about.
So, lo and behold, this ditty showed up.
How does it go?
I'll show you. Watch close, but listen closely.
It's dark in Griffith Park, you can almost see the stars of Hollywood. They flicker and they dance, giving half a chance, all they always would. But the city far below gives off such a glow. Over all we know, it's the only show in town, burning so damn bright that almost every night it's all the light you'll see for miles around. In La La Los Angeles, stars are just a part of where you stay. They have been since the angels left a long time ago. In La La Los Angeles, oh, they fill the night with emptiness. They'd rather drive on a paved sunset than let anything else glow. Well, she came out to this place to sell that pretty face any way she could. She played the game, changed her name, even though she always claimed she never would. She tried so hard to shine, but it's hard to do part-time. She knew all the lines, but couldn't find a scene. Breaks her heart to know she came so far from home just to be a stepping stone on lonely streets of La La Los Angeles, where stars are just a part of where you stay. Have been since the angels left a long time ago.
the drive on a paved sunset. Then let anything else glow. But you should know that when it's dark in Griffith Park, La La is not the only show.
Play a song, or do you want to play a song?
Well, if you have to, go ahead.
It's feeling kind of cold over here, Carl. I'm getting the feeling that you don't like me anymore.
No, you play pretty parts of my songs.
That differs from what side of the stage you're on.
Well, excuse me, Carl, I'm going to play another song that got cut by an artist, okay? I'm not going to rub it in, Carl, but...
Don't worry.
One of us has got to be doing something up here, right?
I'm still waiting.
Okay, all right. This is part of the shtick. I'm the guy that you're supposed to hate, okay? Carl's the guy you're supposed to love.
I don't want to know what I am.
I'm the one.
Actually, this was... the story behind this song, True or False... I was supposed to get together with a songwriter by the name of Tim Nichols, who has written a lot of famous songs. And he canceled on me like a half hour before we were supposed to write, which means that's code for I got a bigger fish on the line. I'm writing with somebody bigger than you. So I just kind of went, yeah, great, okay, no problem. So we went ahead and rescheduled, and about... a month later, when that day came, called me up and said, man, I can't do it again. So did it twice to me. And I thought, you know, I had a song started, but I'm going to just finish it by myself. So, yeah. Finished it by myself thinking it wasn't going to do anything. And I did a demo and kind of threw it at Warner Chapel as I drove by. And yeah, as you normally do. And my publisher, Dale Bobo, called me about a week later and said, hey, Kenny Chesney just cut this song. And it went on, it wasn't a single, but it went on an album that sold 4.5 million. So I wrote it by myself, which bought me this guitar.
And he didn't share any of it.
If I can get in tune, I'll play it for you. And Western. It's called Out of Here.
One, two, three, four.
Let's take off on a permanent vacation. Lock up the house, pack up the station wagon. Make paradise a final destination as long as we're out of here. Ain't no time like the present, they say. Let's cruise on down A1A and put the top down, hit the beach all day, and baby, we'll be out of here anywhere you want to go, as long as it's sunny weather. Let the time fly by, I don't mind, as long as we're together. Baby, south of the border, there's a place I know where James Taylor sang about in Mexico, in the sun so hot we'll forget to go home, and baby, we'll be out of here. Time fly by, long as we're together, Avis. South of the, hold on. I'll think of it in a second. Drive to the country, down to the lake, see if the catfish are jumping and set on bait. And if we come up dry, we can sleep in late, and baby, we'll be out of here. Let's just get out of here. Come on, let's get out of here. Bart's, St. John, St. Elmo, St. John, St. Tom, hell, St. Louis, I don't care. As long as we're out of here, let's just get out of here. Thank you. They like country songs.
It's not. It's country and western.
Oh.
Hey, Carl, you gonna play something pretty?
You'll be the judge.
I will be the judge and the jury, my friend.
So this is, I'm gonna do a blues. You might call it a blues. Some people might refer to it as a blues. Blues song. Why do I call it a blues? Because the name of the song is Weatherman Blues.
Dig it, dig it. Is it a waltz?
It's a blues.
You never know.
It's like the air conditioning is blowing right on these guitars, or my guitar anyway.
Oh, yeah, it's fresh. Awful. I'd like to take this time to order another one of those fine lager beers,
if you don't mind.
Yeah, that'd be delightful. I didn't even make it to the dressing room before I bought an old Eagles t-shirt and a belt. I just did so many cool things to buy over here at the Bowery, I couldn't help it.
This is a fine lager beer. I dig it.
Interesting can. I don't know how to say that, but I dig it. I like it already.
Starts with a lovely guitar intro. Mm.
Just
I don't know nothing but the blues.
I can tell.
Well, Carl, thank you for pulling us all together here tonight, man. This is awesome. You've done a few of these with me. I appreciate you.
What kind of software is on that harmonica?
Yeah. What kind of rig you're
running? It's analog, man. It's
what kind of rig you're running on that tin sandwich?
You're kidding. Alrighty. I could probably use just a little more voice in the monitor if you could. That'd be awesome. Thank you, man. So, do you know this song from the new record coming out in May? This is a little song called Start the World Again, written with a lady named Shannon Hughes up in at a songwriting treat up in Michigan I was on board for. And whisper in my ear everything I need to know. And if you love me, dear, don't ever let me go. We can face the years, no fear of the unknown. Open your arms and let me in. It's time to start the world again. Oh, a tiny bug drove us to our knees. We locked ourselves up, hid away the key. Afraid to love, afraid to even breathe. Too scared to hope, too stunned to grieve. Open your heart and let me in. It's time to start the world again. Oh, I miss the warmth of human touch. I miss the ones I love so much. How will I give myself again? Open back up and learn how to simply begin to start the world again. Were we followed here? Are we alone? I'll cry it out of tears, weary to the bone. And if a little seed could only make the mountains move, could it be that we might find our power to open your arms and let me in. It's time to start the world again. Open your heart and let me in. It's time to start the world again.
Thank you, thank
you.
No. No, I'm done.
I'm gonna get all Bob Ross on you.
That's a thing.
I'm gonna get Bob Ross on him.
I'm a channel Bob Ross.
Who's Bob Ross?
Carl, we can't be friends.
The painter? You don't know Bob Ross, the painter?
You sing the blues and you don't know Bob Ross?
No.
Happy Little Trees. The guy who soft, you know, the therapist.
Yeah, just Big Fro.
It's good, man. We'll get really stoned after the show and I'll show it to you. You're gonna dig it.
What do you mean after?
You guys remember Bob Ross, right?
I need a nap, man.
Thanks, yeah.
What you need to do is get you some happy trees and watch some happy trees.
Happy trees.
All right, so dig it. Imagine a beautiful valley just before the sunrise. There's a little bit of a grayish purple hanging out. Just the heavens up there, and just across this valley you can see the silhouette of these peaks. And a little glow of orange just rests above the tops of these peaks. And just above them you have the very last flickers of the last evening's starlight. That's the stars right there. And as that valley starts to wake up on a beautiful morning, you start to see some definition in those trees and mountains. And just in front of you, you notice a swaying willow tree with its fingertips gently touching a slow-moving river. As those oranges turn to pinks, brilliant yellows, and the first ray of light comes over the crest of the tallest peak, off in the distance you see fishing lines. My son and his father and my father's son went down to the river where the rainbows run. Put lines in the water on a day just begun. My son and his father and my father's son. And we listen as the river glistened along its gentle way. To comfort in the many wonders of what we didn't have to say. Then my son and his father and my father's son took a walk with the mountains where time had begun. Had a stringer of memories when evening had come. My son and his father and my father's son. Tried to pass on what my father passed on before he passed. Oh, life doesn't last long when I'm at last gone. He'll look back. Oh, when my son and his father and my father's son went down to the river that my father loved, put lines in the water. His father done. My son and his father and my father's son. My son and his father and my father's son. My son and his father and my father's son. Thank you.
It's really cool if you're stoned.
My turn?
That's right. Do the let's hear the Joe Galante story. Two nuns were walking down the street. You finish it.
No, I'm not sure I'm following that story, but I'm going to, since everybody's going to the bathroom, this is probably a good time to play this song. It's a real downer of a song, so... We probably got room for a couple more in there if you want. Wasn't recorded by anybody, it's never been a hit. Never been recorded, probably never will.
Me too. Hi, Josh.
Yeah, now you're talking. It was a song that came about from trying to figure out what's important in life. And, took me 69 years. Sorry, let me do that again without Carl. I got short legs, a long face, a little round in the middle, just another John Doe in a John Doe race, an ordinary man doing what I can to find a little peace with a who I am, just a little piece with a who I am. I get wound up, I feel handcuffed, ain't easy in an ordinary. You gotta do a lot of ordinary stuff. Lord, if you can hear me, can you help me understand? And find a little peace with a who I am. Just a little peace with a who I am. Late in the evening when everyone's in bed, that's when the stars come out inside my head, and I'm up in the bright lights at the top of my game. But when I wake up, it's just tough love. Lifeboats, scapegoats, some things you gotta learn how to lose, some things you gotta just let go. As long as I had you, I was a lucky man who found a little peace with the who I am. Just a little piece with the who I am. Thank you.
That's heavy.
So this song, I wrote this in Hollywood. Yeah. after the NAMM show, and I just remember I had just gotten this guitar, actually. And it was like that moment where I was in a really shitty Airbnb with bad plumbing and no internet, or crappy internet. But I wrote the bridge to this verse, and at that point I think, oh, maybe this is a song. You be the judge.
3¾ stars.
I love Griffith Park. Griffith Park at night is unbelievable.
It is, right?
It's one of my favorite places.
You just didn't have to work when you were in LA, it'd be great.
No, it didn't work. Okay, but this starts with another lovely guitar intro. Gotta shut the tuner off.
And he builds studios for a living.
Plays like that,
G-flat, major 13.
I'm awake on a windy day. Any moment I'll blow away. What a surprise. What a surprise. I'm a horse on a carousel. In a race, but no one can tell. What a surprise. What a surprise. Everything that we do becomes a memory that makes us feel alive. Otherwise, we felt nothing at all. Ooh. I'm a coconut in the sun. I got something for everyone. What a surprise. What a surprise. I'm a mountaintop in my bliss. Swing around, give you a kiss. What a surprise. What a surprise. Dum, dum, dum. stop and do it on.
Tasty, tasty, tasty.
Got a record?
Thanks. Thanks.
Mighty smooth. Wrote this little song after visiting a couple of my dad's heroes' graves here in Nashville, George Jones and Marty Robbins. Thinking about my dad, he got me singing in bars since I was about 2 years old, and he played the jukebox and set me up on the bar and gave me to sing along with Hank and Ernest Tubb. These were country artists. Anyway,
who were they? What's their name again?
Yeah. Anyway, I was looking out at the rows and rows of brightly colored plastic flowers strewn under a hot blue sky, thinking about the truth. The sun to hide behind the cloud. I wanna run and never fall down. I'd be number one if I could figure it out. I can face the truth, but please not today. I can face the truth, but please not today. I stood too long, I'd like to sit down. I sung my song, can I take my bow? I can go along, baby, just not right now. I can face the truth, but please not today. I can face the truth, but please not today. I can be a fool, I can be a creep. I can be so cruel, it's a wonder I can sleep. You got your complaints, give it to me straight. But baby, could it wait just one more day? The truth will set me free, the truth will slap my face. Truth is I'm weak, truth is I'm afraid. Afraid of my own life, the damage that I've done. Afraid of what I'm not, what I might become. I can face the truth, please not today. Cut down the flowers, lay them on the grave. Don't count the hours, time will not be saved. I'm not a coward, but I'm tired of being brave. I can face the truth, but please not today. I can face the truth, but please not today. I can face the truth, but please not today. Thank you.
The coop. The coop.
This has been such a joy, gentlemen. I greatly appreciate you allowing me to make noises in your presence while listening to your noises as well.
Give me a lovely noise. Smell it up here.
Where are you going?
I think. What about that? So, as you referenced the truth there, Dana. I got a little truth of my own. You know, it's I'm known as a guitarpender here in Nashville, Tennessee. My buddy Luke said that, and I started laughing.
Guitarpender.
Guitarpender, right? That's me.
I like that.
When you Well, when music chooses you and you are silly enough to think you can make a living at it, you learn to do a lot of other stuff, like construction. I was in a band, and we were doing about 142 shows a year in 7 countries. And COVID hit. We were in Italy when it happened. We were in Austria and Italy when it happened. And it's a weird thing. You know, we were playing really great clubs. We got our first write-up in Rolling Stone, Germany. And it was like, oh, here it goes. Shut down. And a year and a half later, I was swinging a hammer on a construction site because babies got to eat, you know. And that's how it works. But I remember I was about a year and a half into this construction gig, and I got a show at the Bluebird, and I was like, oh, sweet, man, I'm gonna go play the Bluebird tonight. I'm gonna catch that, I want to say big break, you know, you get a lot of breaks in this town, and if your luck crashes into your preparedness and all kinds of other things, you might get, you know, tens of dollars. This particular instance, I had done the most rock and roll thing in a while and changed into my show clothes in a porta potty. And hopped in my truck and was driving out of Dixon, Tennessee, where I was working, and I passed the same barn every day. I said, tonight's the night. Tonight, I'm gonna make some moves. It's gonna be a big break. And I saw that barn and said, ah, but no matter what, I will see that barn tomorrow. There's a song called Back to Work, and it's not depressing at all.
We're hitting the depression right now.
By the way, this is your big break.
Hey, let's dig that. That's right, buddy. I'm gonna hit the go fast. 1 second there. See?
And I'll go to work on Tuesday, feeling Monday in my bones. An extra cup of coffee, 'cause the days are getting cold. The morning comes too early, trying to take its toll on my mind and on my body. Or maybe I'm getting old, 'cause it hurts. But I gotta work today's a little different. I got my guitar in tow. I'm gonna try to get off early, 'cause I gotta play a show. Tonight might be my big break. Hey, you never know. But either way, come Wednesday, it's safe to say I'll go back to work. Well, I got 2 kids and a wife, I had to work. Dreams don't keep on lights, my back hurts. But if it takes twice the sacrifice to make it work, well, it's still more than worth the price. And I know I can't quit dreaming, but I just can't justify letting it be the reason that I can't provide. I could have had an education, all I had to do was try. But I chose an occupation that's leading me and my pride back to work. Well, I got 2 kids and a wife, I had to work. Dreams don't keep on lights, my back hurts. And if it takes twice the sacrifice to make it work, well, it's still more than worth the price. And I'll pay that price. Oh.
Yeah, great song. Great song.
Thank you, man. It ends on that tension. You know, like,
Carl, how many more songs we got?
How many more can we play, man?
Well, yeah.
I can play 100.
I'm just trying to gauge what I should do next.
Cartwheel.
We have no limit, really.
Okay. Well, then I'm gonna tell a story about this next song. Because that's what we're supposed to be doing, is telling these stories. You're supposed to believe it or not believe it. Let's just say it's 1984. I'm in Los Angeles. I just happened to be producing my very first record, and it just happens to be one of the Eagles.
Bullshit.
Is it bullshit? Let's say it was Timothy B. Schmidt, the guy with the long hair.
Nope, never heard of him.
I can't tell you why guy. Let's just say it's him. I'm producing him. All right, we'll go along with it for a second. All right. Let's make it even more ridiculous. Toto is the band. So this is my first record I've ever produced, and Toto's, you know, it's Jeff Porcaro and Lukather and Paige and Timothy. And they're calling me dude because they have no idea who I am and they have no respect for me. And they shouldn't, because it's my first record. Let's just say it's true. May not be. So we record this record, and I'm lucky enough at the time to write some songs with Timothy B. Schmidt. And they release a single. Does pretty good on MTV. It's time for the second single. And Timothy said to the record label, there's a song in there that should be the second single. And the label says, there's no more singles on this record. There are no more singles on this record. And he said, no, you're wrong. There is. It's no, there's on there. No. 10 years later, I moved to Nashville. I'm producing a band called Restless Heart. And I get a call from Joe Galante, the head of the label. And he says, I want you to record this song called Tell Me What You Dream by Timothy B. Schmidt. Have you ever heard of it? Now, at this point, I could say, heard of it. I wrote it. But I thought, that's going to blow it. So I say, nope, never heard of it. Send it over to me. He sends me the song. I take the song. We record it on Restless Heart. It goes to number one. Timothy was right. The record company guy never admitted he was wrong. Truth or not?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it's so bizarre, it's true.
Dude.
Yeah. Here we go.
Okay. We didn't rehearse this one. Disclaimer.
Is it a capo song, too?
Man.
Doggone it.
I was practicing while you were telling the story.
I'm telling the story, and I didn't put the capo on. I'm sorry, ladies.
All right, truth or half-truth right here. I was also in the group.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not supposed to laugh.
They didn't
Your name
call
was
me
Glenn
dude.
Fry.
They didn't call me dude. They just didn't call me.
Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2.
Darling, isn't me. Tell me what.
what you dream at night while you stream. Deep in the night, you reach for your arms. I feel that.
Believe it or not.
My favorite part.
I reach for your arms. You call out a name. It wasn't my horn, and it caused me such pain inside. Tell me what you dream at night while you're sleeping. Tell me what you see at night while you dream. Is it someone else's arms that hold you tight? A darling, is it me? Tell me what you dream at night while you sleep.
Couple.
All of it but that second verse that he blew, that was all true.
I was doing so good. We didn't rehearse it. And I was like, I got this. Sorry, Leah.
Okay, so I've been informed by management. After this, we've got one more. Everybody's got one more song.
Oh. Ooh.
Ooh. Or else.
Cover songs? I was told by you and of somebody else, do not do cover songs.
Well, you just did three. Oh, but you wrote
them. That's not a cover song.
Oh, I wrote those.
That's how you make money.
Damn. Okay, so this next song I have no idea where this song came from. It's kind of celestial and maybe a little bit ironic, confusing or something. There's a Jesus in the song, but it doesn't mean it's the big Jesus. It could be a little Jesus.
Jesus.
Like a dashboard.
Jesus.
Yeah, it could be. So it's a little ambiguous, and there's a celestial quality to this whole thing. But the main thing, and there's kind of a false ending, and then there's a coda, so hold your rotten tomatoes. But the main thing to remember here is don't let the little Jesus tell what the big Jesus what to do. This is called A Real Good Man.
My baby loved me so. She met Jesus and let me go. Now I pray to God that she'll come home. 'Cause I know that although he's a real good man, and I know that although he's a real good man,
guide her safely home to me, 'cause I know that although he's a real good man, and I know that although he's a real good man. And then the angels come.
Strike me as someone who knows the name of all of those chords. Dana, he's playing all kinds of notes in there.
I know he is.
All right, this is our last round right here, fellas.
Make it good.
You better pull out your song.
Yes, sir. Make it good.
I already pulled it out, left it out, and now I'm screwed.
All right, so this is a little song called Thank You, and very grateful to be here tonight, and grateful to just still be here, really, at all, anywhere, and to have been able to live this life of making music. Wrote this little song up in Portland, Oregon. Just having a bad day. I was feeling sorry for myself, which is something rare, but once in a while it happens. And my back was going out, had some bills I couldn't pay, and I'd been away from home for 3 weeks, 3 weeks to go still, out on the road for 6 weeks, driving across the country. Staying with some friends there in Portland, Oregon. It was a rainy day in Portland, surprise. I looked out the window and said, man, I'm just gonna have a pity party for myself. And I'll get tired of myself pretty quickly and snap out of it. So I made myself a cup of orange pekoe tea with no sweetener on purpose. And I sat there and watched it get cold. And to my delight, after a little while, the tea bag starts to disintegrate and the tea leaves are floating on the bitter, tepid water. It's just perfect. I'm gonna chew on my bitter, tepid tea and look out at the crappy, rainy day and feel sorry for myself. So I started in on that and just about had choked that cup of tea down. And the sun explodes out of the clouds. Hummingbirds start swarming the feeders everybody puts in their yards there in Portland. You can't look at a hummingbird and feel bad. So I went out in the backyard and kicked my boots off and wrote this little song for you. Cats live in this house. I'm just a guest passing through. We run around all night, sleep away the afternoon. body. One has a zigzaggy tail, and one is as white as a pearl. One only hides, never lets me into a world. Still I gotta thank you, whoever you are. Thank you for my breaking heart. Thank you for the chance to play my little part. Panther on a windowsill, rabbit in the wood green grass, Rufus and Anna's hearts and wings beating fast. One day I'm filled to the brim, next day the whole thing spills up wide open again. I'm wondering what it's all about. Still I gotta thank you, whoever you are. Thank you for my breaking heart. Thank you for the chance to play my little part. Funny how the clouds pile up when they're only gonna blow away. Funny how each one of us sees a universe in our small way. Cats squint in the sun, high on a blue window day, grinning and purring like they got something to say. If curiosity kills, I'm dying to know what that means. A life of waiting sills won't fill the yearning in between. Oh, oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for the chance to play my little part.
That was awesome.
Thank you.
I want to tell you something. I'm a guitar player, but you know how hard that is to play that stuff and then sing a melody that's completely against that as well.
Dude. That's so hard.
Wow. Dana Cooper, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Badass. What a badass.
For my last selection, I'm going to tell you a story. I'll just save the trouble. It's the truth. I was playing with a band up in Ohio, just south of Columbus, and we were on High Street. That's a true story. And it was, you know, Ohio, when you play Columbus, it's really interesting. It's just far enough away from Nashville that it takes all day to get there, sound check, but it's not far enough away that they'll give you a hotel, so you have to drive back. It's a real fun time. So I did what we normally do. We Rochambeau, paper, rock, scissors to see who's driving first. And if you're smart, you drive first, because then you can take a puff and sleep in the back all the way home. So
we lost the monitors.
Oh, my voice left the monitor. It's kind of an annoying voice anyway, so it's okay. Oh, dope. Oh, I was, yeah. Oh, yeah, beautiful. I appreciate it. Hey, what's your name, man?
Ryan.
How about a hand for Ryan, ladies and gentlemen? He's been running sound all night. Yeah. Appreciate it, Ryan, really do. Make sure you're tipping a bartender. This is a fantastic club. I totally dig it. Great vibe. As I said, I've already purchased a t-shirt, some beers, and a belt. This is a song I wrote on an Ohio highway trying to get home to my babies. Fair.
I admitted it.
Well, it was cold in Grove City. Not a sellout crowd, but we made out okay. Now we're all torn down and rolling out of Grove City. We got the hammer down in the southbound lane. Roll me home, Ohio Highway. Help me make these old wheels fly. Can't take it slow, Ohio Highway. My baby's all alone. I gotta make it home tonight. White painted lights go by slowly. Oh, and the radio is touch and go at best. The road a weary mind is a different kind of lonely. I got 300 miles till I see her smile, and I'll rest. Ah, yes. Roll me home, Ohio Highway. Help me make these old wheels fly. Can't take it slow, Ohio Highway. My baby's all alone. I gotta make it home tonight. In Windman Bridge in Cincinnati, it's finally looking at me, or we'll say goodbye. And then it's straight on through Kentucky to the arms that love me until next time.
Thank you. Thank you. Very good.
Appreciate it. Hey, Carl. Do you mind if I go last?
No. No, that's great.
Truth or half truth?
I mean,
no, it's a wise decision.
Yeah. Josh has a big finish.
No, I don't have a big finish. I just want to. I'm not going to wreck it.
Okay, don't wreck it. Don't spoil the surprise.
Watch the guardrail.
I want to.
Josh doesn't know it, but behind the bar.
What are you going to play, Carl? That's a bunch of chords.
Actually, this song was inspired by a Taylor Swift song, believe it or not.
Wow. Okay. A Swiftie.
Her new album came out. It's a double album, and there was videos of every song on this double album. So I just, let me just see what this is about. I found out later, a client of mine is her guitar player. He got me to see her when she played here, and it's unbelievable, the show. It's just like all of a sudden, you get it. But there was just one lyric in this song. I didn't even know the name of the song, but it was something like, he didn't know that I was what he was looking for. And I said, that was like an aha, and that just, I went off from there. Anyway, this is called Broken Heart Lament. I'm gonna shut off the tuner, sorry. Lost my low end.
Man, I was grooving.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Groove kill.
Here we go.
Oh,
see
yeah.
What I'm saying.
I didn't know till we were through. What I was searching for was you. So long ago, still makes me blue. What I was searching for was you. Still loving you cuts like a knife. You are the best thing in my life. Best thing in my life. Where are you? I can't seem to find a way. If I knew, I'd be a better man today.
Tatz, come on now. I'm serious. That is so, I had no idea. I worked for this guy for years and had no idea that was in there.
It wasn't years. We worked together years ago.
Oh, that's what it was. That's right. Okay. It was years in my mind.
And I worked with I used to have a commercial studio, and Josh used to work there quite a bit with my partner at the time, Larry Lee.
Had no idea you could do this. All this time. All this time. I mean, we're talking when I first moved here, probably late 80s.
Yeah, I moved here in 75. Yeah.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Just Larry brought you over.
Yeah.
And wow. You did Alabama.
I had no idea. You did a bunch of stuff. Yeah. Okay, well, we're going to close with this. I want you to sing along if you can. All of you can sing along if you want. I know management doesn't allow you to do cover songs, so the only thing I'm going to say is I produced the song, I didn't write it, but I produced it. Everybody thinks I co-wrote it, so I think it's okay. It's not really a cover song.
You'd have a different cover.
I mean, I played the guitars on it.
Somebody did Cry Me a River tonight, so
I had to... Yeah. Figure out how to turn that echo around. Anyway.
Yeah. Oh, I start this one.
Yep,
you okay.
Do.
All right. Thought you'd never ask. Did you play that on the record?
I did. But much better.
Lazy yellow moon coming up to the night, shining through the trees. Crickets are singing in the lightning buzz, I'm floating on a breeze. Baby, get ready.
I know, you're looking at me like you didn't produce that. Yes, I did.
Across the field where the creek turns back by the old stump road. It's called a creek, that's right. Gonna take you to a special place that nobody knows. Baby, get ready. You know it now. Ooh, you and me gonna vision in the dark. Lying on our backs and count the stars where the cool grass grows. Down by the river in the full moonlight. We'll be falling.
Almost over and the summer's come and the days are getting long. Waiting on and of all the time to be right just to take you along. Baby, get ready. It don't matter if I sit forever and the fish don't bite. Jump in a river and cool ourselves from the heat of the night. So baby, get ready. Ooh, you and me going fishing in the dark. Lying on our backs and count the stars where the cool grass grows. Down by the river in the full moonlight. Falling in love in the middle of the night, just moving slow. Spend the whole night through, I feel so good to be with you.
You want to take a little solo there, buddy?
Come on, Dana Cooper.
fishing in the dark, lying on a back, sitting counting the stars where the cool grass grows. Down by the river in the full moonlight, we'll be falling in love in the middle of the night, just moving slow.
Josh Leo, Dana Cooper, Carl Tatz,
Phoenix Mendoza.
Thank you and good night.
Thank you, everybody.
Good.